Hello guys, I am back with more repairs. Today on my table, as you can see, it's a Diatone Mamba F4 fly controller from what I've found on the internet. And this one you are looking at right now, I've looked at it before, but as you can see, we have here all the 5 volt switching regulator section burnt out and it's unusable. Recently, I have received another one, which is perfect, except that our MCU is completely burnt. I don't know if you can see that burnt mark there, but this one is a burn mark on the MCU. So this MCU for sure is out of service. So because I received this one with a broken MCU, but in the same time it has a good regulator section, I will try and take the MCU from this one and place it on this one. We have some weird stuff going on here. I don't know what this is, but I will try it and clean it. We have some pads. Weird action going on here. This pad is completely exploded, but I hope we still have here some remains of that pad. And corrosion, a lot of corrosion on this port. I will clean everything around here. This looks to be like corrosion or something. But yeah. Well, let's start. And first I want to take this MCU out. Let's get in a little bit closer. And for us to take it out, we just need some flux here. Take our hot air. Right now is set up on 500 degrees C and full blow, but that doesn't mean that I will go full blow on the MCU itself. I will keep my distance. And when we see the solder on the pads melt, then we can go in for a grab. I hate this lead-free solder. Well, it's good for your health, but pretty messy and hard to work with. And now let's take this broken MCU out. Now, while the board is still a little bit hot, I'm going to touch up and mingle in some leaded solder. and suck all the remains on my solder wick, cleaning out the bit, the pads, as best as I can. Okay. And from here. Quiet. I don't know if you can see it or not, but whoever designed this PCB went on and placed some solder mask on this pin, so this pin doesn't have any type of copper, because he needed that via hole right there. So, yep. And now we should take a Q-tip with some alcohol and clean all this gunk remains from here. So, now we have a way better looking PCB. Now you have two options. One will be to use solder paste, which is nothing else than flux with little balls of solder. Or, if you don't have that, just go in and place fresh solder on those pads. And that's usually enough to have the MCU or the IC soldered down pretty good. And even if you have a pad that is not well soldered down, you will just come in and touch up any pin that is not connected or it has a very loose connection. Okay, so it looks pretty decent. Now, because I've messed all the flux that's inside my solder wire, I will clean up a bit more. And as you can see, we have enough solder on those pads. Now, we take some more flux, fresh flux, and place it here. That will help our IC to sit there nicely. The only thing we need to care about is the orientation of the IC. It matters because this is how we know where pin number one is. For example, we have on the PCB that round white corner there, and all the other corners are right angle. We have it roughly in the position we wanted. This here represents our pin number one, so it starts from here, from one to whatever count the MCU has. Good. And now, the time of truth. We are going to heat up the board easily. We don't go like crazy on it. And I'm not going to push the air from the sides, because that will push my MCU off its position. It will move a bit, but hopefully I'm not going to work it out too much. The benefit of changing the solder type is that leaded solder melts on a low temperature. So as you can see, we almost have all the pads melted now. We just arrange it a bit and push it down. Or we can rearrange it a bit. It's not recommended. Yep, now it's right. You can nudge it when you press on it to be sure you have a good connection. Now, if you want to check that every pin is connected, you just go in with a tweezer like this and push on every pin, and if it moves, it means that you don't have a solid connection there. But as I can see, I have very good connections everywhere, so I'm not too worried about that. But if you want to touch up some pads, you can. You just take a very fine tip, go in with some solder on the pin you want to touch up and do it like this. As you can see, the pin will draw enough solder, and obviously you need a little bit of flux there to help you out in this touching up. Obviously this is overdoing it because it was soldered the right way from the beginning, but I'm just doing this for you to see how would you touch up some pads. Obviously be sure not to bridge any pins because that would be wrong, and it's fixable. I mean, it's not the end of the world if you bridge two pins, because you always have solder wick to help you, because solder wick will suck up any solder that's there. As you can see, I have a bridge now, and if I want to fix it, I'm just going to use the solder wick. And my pins are now free and in the same time connected. Now I want to go over all the PCB and check everything up. For example, this doesn't look that nice. I don't know, it has something inside, maybe wire left there, or the pad is just broken. Let's use the solder wick here and suck everything from here. Yeah, that's a wire. Man, it's pretty difficult to take out wire from these tiny holes. Oh well. Putting some fresh solder there everywhere we can. This will clean all those nasty corrosion stuff, the green, yellow things. Okay. I like this tip because it has way more power than all the others. Okay. Let's turn it and check all the pins. As I've said, we have some weird pads here which look pretty weird. So, solder. I don't know if it saw some water damage or something, but it looks pretty damn corroded and problematic. Hopefully we can fix it and have it working again. I don't know what this pad does, but oh well. So, other than those pins here, this FC actually looks pretty good. Let me clean it a bit. As I've said, alcohol and a toothbrush. Clean it on the other side too. Ok, Okay, this is our little FC cleaned up. Doesn't look that bad. To be honest, I'm quite surprised. It turned out quite okay. There still are remains of what happened to this FC. I don't know exactly what. So now let's see if the FC is actually working. Okay, so I'm flashing now the latest version of Betaflight because I guess this board had a different firmware in it. I have no idea what type of firmware it was, but... So, guys, this was a pretty simple repair. You can do at home without any issue. Just transplant good parts from broken PCBs to other PCBs. You can do this from different boards also, but for me, I was lucky to have an identical PCB. But you can take same type of MCU from a board and place it on other boards, put the MCU into bootloader mode and flash your version of Betaflight. If you have any question, guys, please leave that in the comment section. Also, don't forget to press that subscribe button, and if someone has the willingness of donate broken stuff for me to make more videos, he can contact me over on social media. Thank you very much, guys. Until the next time, bye.